Hey, what's up, folks? This is Jesse with Keeping Real Finance, the channel that always has your back and tells it like it is. Today's video is going to be all about Swipe and the SXP token. So usually when I review projects, it's either one, because it was a request, or two, because I've seen it on Twitter. Well, SXP is one of these tokens that keeps popping up on Twitter. Usually all the big dogs have this one somewhere at the bottom of their list of tokens that they're following, that they think their moon bag is packed for, right? And so I went ahead, I looked into this one. I can see why they're thinking that, all right? This kind of goes down the rabbit hole of Binance-related stuff. I'll be talking about that in the video. I'll be giving you a thorough review, as always, including who the founder or founders are, where we think this project is headed by year-end 2021. I'll be giving you some news on it, some tokenomics. I got a little bit of everything in this video, so you are not going to want to miss this one. Extremely impressive project, okay? So, as always, make sure you hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and if you click the bell, you'll be made aware whenever I post time-sensitive content just like this. And now, let's get it going. So what is Swipe? Well, Swipe is a company that brings crypto to commerce and standard banking through customized APIs. So, it's a card payment infrastructure for fiat currency, NFT tokens, cryptocurrencies, digital assets, and commodities. Now, essentially, Swipe powers a platform that enables businesses to create card programs for customers to spend anything globally. So how does it work? Well, businesses create, manage, and distribute branded virtual and physical cards, while Swipe manages the regulatory, compliance, and network responsibilities. Now, this allows the business to quickly launch their program with Swipe's banking partners and direct licenses. So Swipe connects and is partnered with major payment networks to enable businesses to quickly create crypto to fiat-funded card programs. Now, Swipe Ramps enables a full fiat channel for payments into and out of any asset class. And you can tokenize your card for a touchless experience with Swipe-powered debit cards that enable access to Apple Pay, Google Pay, and Samsung Pay. So the sales pitch is custom branded and virtual and physical cards. We have programmable settings such as enabling foreign transactions, locking, reissuing, MCC restrictions, PIN controls, and more. There's compliance ready, so Swipe handles the KYC and identity verification. Businesses are then able to leverage Swipe's licenses and banking partners. And we have real-time access, so full control over real-time, where the business can create logic to approve or decline scenarios with full control of transactions and authorizations. Now, furthermore, Swipe claims they make issuing crypto-powered debit cards simple, borderless, and programmable. So 99% uptime of APIs that power Swipe. We've got 135-plus countries, and 30-plus countries supported globally and growing. Now, the bottom line is Swipe was designed for developers by creating comprehensive APIs that can create a tailored product in no time. Now, for the top clients, Binance and FTX. That alone is massive. We know how big Binance is. Now, as I was just talking about the Binance debit card just the other day, now we know who supplied the APIs for it. It was Swipe, okay? Now, Swipe has two pricing options, standard and premium. For staking 300,000 SXP, premium offers cheaper fees. Now, for a little background, Swipe was founded by Joselito Lizarondo, or JL is what he goes by, an early Bitcoin investor. He currently is the CEO of Swipe. He is also the CEO and founder of Venus. He's involved in quite a few things, okay? Now, in July 2020, guess who bought Swipe? I'll give you a hint. Binance. Binance owns Swipe. They own Swipe too. Crazy, right? So for some news, Swipe acquired Spend.com in March, adding technology for a variety of different crypto, fiat banking, and card issuing products. They had the Swipe Ignition Sale, where Binance users could spend SXP-wrapped Ethereum or SXP-wrapped BNB in exchange for discounted XVS, that is Venus, or discounted STRK, which is Strike, which was launched by Spend.com. Now, Swipe Wallet version 2 roadmap, which aims to give the user access to all of the following decentralized services along with their Swipe card. So the highlights include non-custodial, temporary card wallet, DeFi exchange, Venus, where users can earn on idle crypto with farm rewards, SXP gas, Swipe Layer 2, Swipe's own solution to help with congestion and high gas fees with the Ethereum transactions, right? Now, in quarter one, SXP updates and upgrades is the focus. Quarter two, the main focus here is Swipe Wallet V2. Quarter three, we have 10 million SXP burn and stealth releases. And quarter four is Swipe Financial full launch. Now, the highlights of which include finalizing their Visa membership application and integration, working with MasterCard to evaluate the crypto API they plan to offer, and finalizing acquisitions. Now, finalizing banking as a service acquisition of a US-based crypto-based company is just one of those, right? Now, lastly, the most recent April update outlined the Swipe V2 white paper, including Swipe API, Swipe Swap, Swipe Chain, Swipe NFT, and products and stealth, with the mission being to create a bridge between crypto and commerce for our business partners paid in SXP, and building a full cross-chain decentralized automated market maker powered by SXP. Now, they also confirmed that JL would be burning, listen to this, his entire founder's supply of 50 million SXP tokens worth roughly $200 million at the time of that posting. He's just lighting them on fire. Crazy, right? That tells you he doesn't need the money. Wow, you know? So, let's talk token. So, SXP is the native token of Swipe. For a little tokenomics, so Swipe staking will be discontinued to remove inflation. That's key. In its place will be other staking mechanisms from other protocols. Swipe will continue burning SXP from on-chain activities with wallet contracts, gas burns, ignition IWO burns, Swipe swap burns, with a total end goal of 100 million total supply. JL will burn 10 million SXP, worth 25 million in August 2021 from the founder's unlock. And Swipe Swap will allow LP stakers, that's liquidity pool stakers, to earn from on-chain transactions. Now, as of this recording, Swipe was ranked number 143 with a market cap of $448 million only, okay? Now, with 91 million SXP out of 239 million in circulation, roughly only 38% is in circulation. Now, if we insert the chart here, Swipe kicked off the year at 74 cents. Today, 5/7/2021, it's trading at $4.89, or a 6.6x on the year. Now, if we insert the zoomed out trading view chart here, the channel that it has been trading in would end the year somewhere between $10.60 and $13.33, which effectively is a 2 to 3x. Now, if we get blast-off mode with altcoin season, which we've already started to see, we saw it with, you know, Ethereum Classic, we saw it with Telcoin, obviously Dogecoin is kind of doing what it's doing, whatever. But we are starting to see this with multiple coins where they're doing a 4, 5, 6x over the course of a couple of days, right? Now, you add in all of the token burning with the goal to burn essentially 139 million more tokens. Holy cow. And a CEO that just burned 50 million tokens worth $200 million, plus the interconnection with Venus and the $11 billion that's locked, total value locked in Venus, right? Plus their own by Binance. And this project has mega success written all over it. As does Venus, which will probably be my next video. Well, FYI there, right? Now, we also know how Binance made the Binance Visa with Swipe's API. So my price prediction is at the lowest, you're easily going to double or triple your money on Swipe this year. I think that is more than possible. Now, the ceiling, though, for this year, that could be a 10x or better. It really could, especially if we light a fire under this one, like we just lit that fuse with Telcoin, right? So that could totally happen here. Now, it all comes down to the leadership of JL combined with Binance and the Binance Smart Chain. You know, obviously we know that's a winner. I just did the video on that. With the leadership of CZ and Venus also in the project here, this project just has massive implications and lots of money behind it. So in the long run, this one has home run written all over it. Now, being part of the Binance Smart Chain, obviously you can find this on Binance. One option that I was doing just the other day with Reef is going through Trust Wallet. I'll probably do a video on Trust Wallet at some point. I haven't done one yet. But Trust Wallet is owned by Binance. So if you're in a market where you don't get the full access to the full Binance, like right here in the USA, well, how do you get around that? Well, you get around it by getting the Trust Wallet app. You buy BNB coin, you swap it to the Binance Smart Chain coin, then you swap that to whatever coin you're trying to get. So I did that just the other day with Reef. I picked up a substantial amount of Reef. I'm probably going to do the exact same thing here with Swipe, where I will pick up a substantial amount of SXP. As I stated, this coin is a no-brainer. This is why all the big dogs on crypto have it down there in their list that, you know, just about everyone seems to have SXP. And if you look into it, that's what this project is all about. So hopefully we've covered everything in the video today. I'm sure there's so much here that it's very possible I may have missed something, but hopefully I've communicated to you that you can see why this project could be so big, right? And, you know, just the leadership of JL burning his entire founder supply. You know, you look at the total value locked in Venus, $11 billion. And it's just, wow. I mean, just mind-blowing numbers, just absolutely crazy. And as I mentioned at the very beginning of the video, CZ actually brought it up on Twitter the other day that he couldn't believe that the founder was essentially burning his entire supply. And he said, you know, it's kind of an honor to have guys like this part of the Binance Smart Chain, right? And that's what it comes down to. So the bottom line here, very impressive project. I am highly impressed with it. Am I going to be getting into this one? Yes, I am. Okay. So just throwing that out there, I think it's got a lot going for it, and it has a very bright future. All right, so that's it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure to hit the like button. Don't forget that I am also on Twitter at KIR Finance, where I'm tweeting and retweeting on a regular basis. You can find me there. And for a friendly reminder, this is Jesse with Keeping It Real Finance, the channel that always has your back and tells it like it is. And I will see you on the next one. Later.